Featuring today an extraordinary speaker, International Atomic Energy Agency Director General Rafael Mariano Grossi, in a conversation with New York Times White House correspondent and national security correspondent David Sanger.
You came into this job, and I know from our own conversations that you, you know, you thought you understood what it was, but what's been your biggest surprise?
The big surprise was also your biggest surprise and everybody's biggest surprise, and it was the pandemic. You know, I come to the, you know, take the directorship general of an international organization, and all of a sudden the world collapses. You cannot fly. You cannot send out your inspectors. You don't know what's going to happen. And especially when you have hot potatoes like Iran or the DPRK or many other cases, including safety, security. And frankly, you are confronted with a completely new situation, one you were not expecting 2 months into your new job.
What do you draw from the Fukushima experience that we need to know for both nations that are experienced at managing their nuclear enterprises and for the newcomers?
All habits die hard normally in everything, but also in this world of nuclear. And there is always this mantra that nuclear safety, of course, is a national responsibility. Of course it is, because a nuclear power plant, which sits in the United States or in Argentina or in Italy, or no, in Italy they don't have it. But anywhere, of course, it's the country that has to ensure these things. But there is an ever increasing work at a global scale, because, of course, you know, the whole thing is as strong as the weakest link. For me, Chernobyl was a bigger cultural and institutional change. Fukushima perhaps was a reminder of a need for strict observance of standards and strengthen them. Actually, it is important to go to the documents and see that what happened at that time was to a certain extent because of lack of observance of recommendations that the IAEA had made to Japan before, including at a time of a previous earthquake that had impacted the Kashiwazaki Kariwa.
If you could tell us a little bit about some of the things you think are most important that the agency has done since then, and if there are areas where you think states still need to do more in order to avoid another catastrophe.
Fukushima, of course, made us redouble our efforts, but there was no Copernican change in that, you know, we reviewed very thoroughly and meticulously all the safety standards. There were some adjustments, like, as you say, there were a number of stress tests that were carried out almost all over the world. And I should also give credit to other organizations that were very active on this at the European level, at the Latin American level, in Asia, one of the World Association of Nuclear Operators. I mean, it was an effort, it was a global effort, really, to do whatever it was necessary. And I think there were good improvements. From there, to say that without all these things, we were on the verge of a catastrophe, no. I think we have to be serious and say that. But safety is a process. Safety is like taking your morning shower. You do it every day or shaving, although I see that you have a beard. But for those who do it, we do it every day, and you cannot stop. So safety is a process. It's not something some people sometimes say, okay, what did you do? What did you decide? Are we now safe? No, we are never safe. We are always safe, and we are never safe. It's something that is a constant, constant process.
Well, thanks so much, Mr. Chernobyl. I appreciate it.
Thank you very much. I enjoyed it. Thank you.